Okay, are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
Well, it's a big step for a young man.
I'm ready.
But we're right here behind you if you are ready.
I said I'm ready.
Okay, okay. In we go.
Yeah.
Hello, I'd like to buy a packet of condoms.
Oh, God, it's a woman. I'll use a crisp packet. Seriously, they're very reliable. Especially cheese and onion. Don't hit the bell.
Good morning, miss.
Goodbye, miss.
Can I help you, son?
No.
Yes.
16 today.
Lewis, what are you doing?
And up for fun.
Come on, stop it.
I'm a big boy now, or so they say. So if you serve,
I'll be on my way.
You
no, you don't. Get back there.
That's right.
Box of balloons with a feather-like touch. Pack of party poppers that pop in the night. A toothbrush and a spray, plastic ring. Oh God, Miss Clay has just walked in.
Welcome to the house of fun. Now I've come of age. Welcome to the house of fun.
What are you doing?
Stop it!
Welcome to the lion's den. Temptation's on its way. Welcome to the house of...
No, 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 miss. You misunderstood.
16, big boy.
Full pint in his manhood.
I'm up to date on the days today, so if you serve, I'll be on my way.
Welcome to the house of fun. Now I've come of age. Welcome to the house of fun. Welcome to the lion's den. Temptation's on its way. Welcome to the house of...
I'm sorry, son, but we don't stock party gimmicks in this shop. Try the house of fun. It's quicker if you run. This is a chemist, not a joke shop.
You've given me Featherlight. I wanted Rough Rider.
No, no, no. Billy, stop it. Angie!
White, how can I put this?
We deserve a man with prospects.
We're not going to find one round here.
We might. If you get to university.
And you won't get to university if you're 6 months up the dump.
Look, just because he's 16 today, it don't mean we're immediately gonna sleep together.
Sweet.
Oh. Come on. Just come on.
Hello, son.
Can I help you, miss?
Sis? I presume you have statistics in a place like this.
In what sense?
Mr. Watson!
Thank you.
Spermicide.
Oh, God. Do you do double strength?
Are there condoms that are twice as thick
and half the length? Mr. Watson!
For sake, just give me a packet of three.
And a chastity belt without no key.
I'm sorry, girls, but we don't stock half of that stuff in this shop.
Why?
Try the Royal Free. It's a hospital, you see. And this is a chemist. Not a hardware shop!
Come on, come on.
Right, you can have a vanilla thriller,
okay.
A chocolate log, or a penis colada.
I don't want it in any flavour.
Oh, okay. Luminous, do you want it?
Non-luminous.
No flavour, non-luminous.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Okay, extra safe, double thick, two different types of spermicide.
Thank you so much for...
Oh, we see. That's only what he's wearing. For you, we got...
The FemSafe Femidom.
It's like having sex with an Asda bag, but it's okay.
And finally, for the ultimate safety, can we recommend...
Don't Go On A Date?
Girls, I know you don't like him. I love Joe Casey, okay?
Oh, he has done it! He has found the world's classiest condom.
What?
The Surprise Harmony.
Colour?
Normal?
Flavour?
None?
Close?
No.
Thank you. We now have 5 minutes to get back to our house. Why is it called a Surprise Harmony?
Well, when you reach orgasm, it plays The Power of Love.
I didn't say Mary.
Oh, my God.
Father wears his Sunday best.
Not so fast.
Mother's tired, she needs a rest. The kids are playing up downstairs. Oh. Sister's sighing in her sleep. Oh. Brother's got a date to keep. He can't hang around. Mum, what are you doing?
Our house.
All right, boys.
In the middle of our street.
Our house.
Thank you, mate.
In the middle of our...
There's always something happening and it's usually quite loud. Yeah. Our mum, she's so house proud. Nothing ever slows her down and a mess is not allowed.
That's right.
Our house. Woo. In the middle of our streets. Our house.
Come on, let's dance.
In the middle of our house. Is our castle and our king. Our house. Yeah. Up. In the middle of our.
Now you spread word round Camden that this street is a no-go zone for any of them scummy drug dealers out of that high-rise.
Yes.
This isn't just any street.
No.
This is Casey Street.
Yes.
NW1.
Yes.
No one touches that name.
Our house. Woo. In the middle of our streets. Our house.
Right, got it.
In the middle of our house. Is our castle and our king. Our house.
What's up, buddy?
In the middle of...
This is a big moment, Mum.
I know it is. First girl you've ever brought home.
Go on, I know you're dying to straighten my hair.
You better be good enough for my golden boy.
She is, Mum. She really is.
Wahey! Billy and Angie Moulton!
Wahey! Tall and ugly bastard!
Judge, your date.
Sarah, your future.
Mum, this is Sarah. Sarah, this is our mum. Our MO. Our Lewis.
Hi.
And our house!
Yes! In the middle of our streets, our house! In the middle of our lipstick, our house!
You alright?
Is our castle and our dream, our house! In the middle of our house! In the middle of our streets, our house! In the middle of our house! Is our castle and our dream, our house!
Okay, steady, careful, it's slippy.
Where are we going?
Uh-huh.
Oh, come on.
Somewhere very special.
Why?
Well, it has to be a special location for a special night.
Yeah, but Camden Canal? Most people normally go to the cinema on their birthday.
Yes, well, 16 isn't any old birthday, is it? I mean, not presuming, just because, you know, now that I'm legal... We'd automatically, you know.
No, well, neither was I.
What's in the bag?
Sandwiches.
Told you that.
Leave.
No, I didn't bring any food. That's a really good point.
The back. See, you got the back of your trousers wet now.
Yeah, but that doesn't matter, does it? These are my school trousers.
What's that?
What?
Can you hear music? Can you hear the power of love?
Anyway.
Oh, it's got muffled now.
Anyway, sorry about the big family send-off back there.
I know. Didn't see your dad.
No. Well...
Billy and Angie said he was in prison for a bit.
Yeah. Bet they did.
Why was he?
'Cause he lost his job. And he got into housebreaking. And he wasn't there tonight because when he came out of prison, the bastard never came home.
He disappeared.
I didn't just disappear. I died.
Do you know what happened?
No.
I got in a fight. A stupid fight somewhere a long way from here.
Joe?
Someone pulled a knife on me. I messed it all up, son.
Your mates think I'm gonna end up like him, don't they?
Hey, Joe. Look, I don't want to scare you off, but the moment I saw you, I knew, you and me, that we were supposed to end up together. And I don't care what anyone else thinks, Joe Casey. I want to go into law, and it's because I reckon I'm a pretty good judge of character.
Well, I'm not going to end up like him. Come on. Let me show you something.
Hey, I was going to kiss you then.
It's important.
Joe, what the hell are you doing?
Come on. Nip up here.
It says keep off.
Now listen to her.
Look, I want to show you something. I bet your mates have never seen this.
You're breaking in, Joe.
You said that you didn't care what anyone else thinks. Well, I do.
It's a crime.
Now listen to the girl.
It's still a building site. No one's moved into these new flats.
Sunshine, crime was the worst mistake I ever made with my life. Well, technically the worst mistake was arguing about a Twix with a smackhead who had a meat knife.
The Irish estate. My mum's family built that. My great-granddad was a gang leader on it. So good, they named a street after him. Look, Casey Street. There's even some story that mum goes on about that they gave him the house, you know, our house.
This is the police.
Oh, my God.
Is someone out there?
Oh, my God, it's the police. What are we going to do?
Run.
What? We have to give ourselves up.
We have to run away.
Don't do what I'd have done.
It's wrong.
It's not that simple.
It is simple.
Go.
This is the police. Stay where you are, son.
These kind of moments decide your life, Joe. Let me show you. Of good versus bad. Crucial advice to a son from a dad. Two different paths to let the boy know which one to take, which direction to go. 'Cause without low there is no high. If nothing fell there'd be no sky. Is it always so very clear? It's the days that separate the night. The shadows by which we recognize the light. It's the simple equation of night versus day, of owning up or running away, of following blindly the pathway of flight, miscalculating you're wrong and you're right. 'Cause without low there is no high. If nothing fell there'd be no sky. Is it always so very clear? Oh, where do we go from here?
We got away. We made it.
Joe,
we're fine.
Now listen. Now, I appreciate it's slightly comical for a dead criminal to be handing out advice, but you chose to run from the police. So you're the one that's heading down the dark path, son, and bad follows bad. You just watch.
We got away. We made it. We're fine. We just... Oh, God. Are you okay? What?
I can't believe you did that! I can't believe you ran away! Yeah. I thought I knew you! I don't know you at all, do I?
Sarah, we didn't get caught. It's not like we got caught.
A policeman did that, Joe! That's how close I was! You probably didn't notice. You were 50 metres across the building site!
Sarah, I...
Maybe I'm not cut out for law. Maybe I'm not such a good judge of character!
Sarah? Sarah!
Now, what did I tell you? Bad follows bad.
Sarah!
My girl's mad at me. I didn't want to see the film tonight. I found it hard to say. She thought I had enough of her. Why can't she see? She's lovely to me, but I like to stay in and watch TV on my own every now and then. All right, Joe. My girl's mad at me. Been on the telephone for an hour. We hardly said a word. I tried and tried, but I could not be heard. Why can't I explain?
Why can't she see?
Why do I feel this pain?
She's lovely to me, but I like to stay in.
She doesn't understand.
And watch TV on my own.
She takes it all the wrong.
Exactly.
Hey, how you doing, laddos? Bloody hell, I tell ya. My girl
doesn't exist.
Yeah, fair point. Pint of lager, Dave. So how can we now here with what's her face?
No, no,
she's not my girl now, is she?
Hey? Well, she should be his
she
girl.
She should be, but
she's mad at him.
Yeah.
Oh,
really?
Oh, God, he's been on the phone Wednesday night. Thursday night, right?
We talked
last
and talked
night,
until it was like...
Gets to like where he thinks he's agreed
and
all, yeah?
I thought we'd agree.
He thought he talked over it all and then he goes and
I
says something stupid like...
Out.
Of course, right, now, whenever he tries to say anything
now
about
when
the whole
I try to speak...
She sort of says it is
I don't care.
She says...
I'm out of
and care. Now
she says... I'm weak.
All right, lads, you've had enough.
I've not. I'm fine. Come on, mate.
Have
one whiskey.
Whoa! That's not funny,
come on,
man.
Mate.
Yeah,
that way.
That way.
And then that way.
I'm a bit pissed.
I've got you, mate.
Oi, Lewis, get up.
End of the day, who needs women? I don't. Lewis, you don't need women in the same way that somebody who's never had a chocolate biscuit doesn't need a chocolate biscuit.
I love chocolate biscuits.
Why do I feel this pain? She doesn't understand, she doesn't realise. She takes it all the wrong way.
Well, well, well.
Oh, God, it's Reese.
Hey?
Just all right, mate?
Oh, good night, girls.
Absolutely. Come on, big man.
You all right, Reese?
Don't cry over spilt women, mate. There's plenty more fish in the sea. You'll always get something after you tackle. Believe our paths crossed the other night.
In what sense?
Billy and Angie said that you was in one of them flats up Camden Keys.
Yeah, well, I
Me too! In fact, thanks to the police running round after you, they didn't catch me coming out of the show flat with a widescreen. Very impressive.
Right.
In fact, if you're interested, I might even let you in on a little business idea I've had.
What, you and me?
16, mate. Got to think about life now.
You're not coming back to do your exams?
Up to you, mate.
Yeah.
You could do your exams. Or, on the other hand, Joe Casey, if you want, as of today, school's out.
Hey?
Come on, brother, let's have a song. Breaking all the rules, having fun and playing fools, smashing up the woodwork tools. All the teachers in the pub, passing round a ready rub, trying not to think of when the lunchtime bell will ring again. Oh, what fun we had, but did it really turn out bad? All I learned at school was how to bend or break a rule. Oh, what fun we had, but at the time it seems so bad, trying different ways to make a difference to the headmaster's had enough today.
All the kids have gone away. Next door school.
Every term that is a rule. Sits alone and bends his cane. Same old bastard again. All the small ones tell tall tales. Walking home and smashing snails. house. Oh, what fun we had. But did it really turn out bad? All I learned at school was how to bend or break the rule. Oh, what fun we had. But at the time it seems like bad. Trying different ways to make a difference to the days.
Last day of school is in so many ways. The first day of the rest of your lives. And I urge you to remember the prosperity of my freedom. Lion's den, temptation's on his way. Welcome to the lion's den, temptation's on his way. Welcome to the lion's den, temptation's on his way. Welcome to the lion's den, temptation's on his way. Welcome to the lion's den, temptation's on his way. Welcome to the lion's den, temptation's on his way. Welcome to the lion's den, temptation's on his way. Welcome to the lion's den, temptation's on his way.
Of night versus day, of owning up cleanly or running away. One path will lose you, the girl that you love. This path you're white as the wings of a dove. And without love there is no high. Without love no stars, no sky. This will rise where that one fell. It wasn't hard to tell.
Quiet, please.
Right, Joe. You chose the right path, I'll tell you, son, because honesty is the best policy. Now, you just watch.
Your Honour, I did break into that building site, but I didn't nick any stuff. To be honest, I was just trying to impress someone.
My client then showed admirable moral fibre in staying to give himself up.
Yes.
And now acknowledges his mistake, in light of which, could we plead for leniency?
Right, well, I will consider that plea. Provided there are no further submissions.
There is an additional submission in this case.
Aye?
The council are aware that Harold Pressman Developments Limited are failing to secure any purchasers for the Camden Keys luxury villas. Now, they attribute this to their being located near the so-called Irish estate.
Hey, there's no trouble from Casey Street.
Mrs. Casey.
No! Any trouble round here comes from that bloody high-rise.
Mum.
Heron House. Heroin House, they should have called it. Every day you see them driving around with their stereos on like the bloody drugs equivalent of an ice cream van.
Thank you.
The council feels that petty criminal activity is acting as a disincentive. As a result, local magistrates are being urged to hand down short custodial sentences.
No, hang on, this is the right
part. As a clear message to any would-be young criminals.
No, custodial, not my baby, no.
These are indeed extenuating circumstances. I will therefore look to give you a discretionary 3-month custodial sentence.
But he gave himself up!
Also,
he did it for me!
Don't call him bastard, Auntie Cass.
He did it for me!
I didn't run. I gave myself up to the police.
Baby! Joe! Please!
A train ride till Tuesday. A platform far away.
Scarlet shades of evening move clouds of grey.
Awaken, arriving, the dirty station where he passes crowds of people who don't see him there. Here's a desert island room for a man who's cast away.
This is it, this is it, is this my heart? I miss you with all my heart. This is not, is this not my heart?
One new face.
One Ed Case.
Greasy. I know you from school.
We got done the same night, you and me. Camden Keys. May I?
No.
One shoelace, cardboard suitcase. One passport from the Queen.
One room for a light bulb where no one's been.
I take it this really is sherbet. Typical.
Well, this is it. This is it. Is this my heart? I miss you with all my heart. This is not. Is this not my heart?
This empty room where he's marooned with nothing left to say. But in the dark, he thinks of home far away.
Papers and begin.
Camden, still Camden, sort of okay, sort of fine. How are you feeling, Joe? Are you feeling?
Rise and shine, visiting.
Oi, it's my mum here. She should be. It's usually about this time of the month she realises I haven't come down for me breakfast.
I'm not going to cry. I am not going to cry. Oh, baby.
Mum, you shouldn't come if it upsets
oh,
you.
Oh, this is so wrong.
Come here.
Oi! No contact. Sorry.
I did bring you a cake, but they wouldn't let me in with it. No? They let the other mothers in with theirs. They just said mine was too crap. You'll do right. You will do right. Golden boy, Joe Casey, you are. And I'm not the only girl in Camden who thinks that.
We're 16, Mum. This is the summer they always go on about. Sarah would be mad to wait.
This is it. This is it.
Is this my heart?
Emma and Lewis have started working at a car wash. Bollocks. I spent so long trying to choose a brilliant first thing to say. Can't believe I went for that one.
Have you started anything new with anyone? Is the next one going to be longer? Only I put my bag down.
Is this no?
Of car washing is a much maligned and underestimated art. There's a lot more to it than sloshing the water on, waxing the bonnet and putting tyre black on the wheels.
Sure.
I'm lying, of course. There's the water, wax and the tyre black. Off you go.
See? I told you it wouldn't be a long training period.
What? He hasn't even asked about my GCSE results. I could be anyone. I could just run off with this bucket.
Prepare to make easy money.
Oh, yeah. Wicked.
Best of luck, mate. Yeah. Watch you don't scratch it.
Oh, my God, it's not. Please tell me it's not.
Hello, girls.
All right, Reese.
It's sad, isn't it? Well, Joe Casey had a girl waiting for him when he got out of the Institute. The only thing waiting for me was a Mazda MX-5. I wonder whose it was.
Well, well, well. It's the water monkeys.
Why'd you bring Reese here to get his car washed?
Yeah, that is so unfair. You knew it was our first day.
No, we didn't.
Did we?
Oh, no, we did.
Guys, guys, yeah. Look who's back.
Hey, whoa. All right, mate.
All right, Joe.
Hello, Joe. You all right?
Yeah.
So how was prison?
Hmm? It wasn't prison. It was a Young Offenders Institute.
Right. Starter prison.
Hey, yeah, do you get beat up with socks full of snooker balls? And is there, like, one bloke, right, who gets stuff sent in from outside and you'll have to give him a bit of your chocolate, yeah? And his cell is, like, dead nice, you know, with a carpet, right? And all the warders are, like, nicer to him and he's called, like, king or something.
No.
Shame.
You learn things, mate, that's what it's like.
Oh, really? You did exams?
You don't have to have exams to do every job in the world, do you?
That's true.
Yeah. Ta-da!
Hey, yeah, I mean, we could have a word with Ray.
Yeah, see, the art of car washing is a much maligned...
He could come and work with me. Little idea I've had, Joe, for a business venture.
It's all right, Reese, I'm not getting into all that. See, what they teach you in there is pride. So you can come out, stand in front of the world and say, hey, my name's Joe Casey, ex-young offender, take me or leave me.
Received a letter just the other day.
Here we go.
Don't seem they wanna know you no more.
You what?
They laid it down, giving you their score. Within the first two lines of bluntly red.
You not come see us no more. Keep away from my door.
Billy, give me that back. You're
don't
right.
Come round here no more.
I agree.
What on earth did you do that for?
Cow, cow.
Her aunt, she don't wanna know, she says.
What?
Uncle, he don't wanna know, he says.
What?
We're disgraced to the human race.
He says.
How can you show your face when you're a disgrace to the human race?
God! Best of luck! Keep smiling!
Yeah.
Joe! Seriously, it's great you're interested in being a shell stacker here at Oscar's Toy Farm. Do you think you'd fit in?
Oh, definitely. I love this kind of environment.
Right.
I love kids. I've got enormous commitment.
Ooh.
I'm also proud to sit here and say that I'm a reformed young offender.
All right. Living endorsement.
You said
the intention that you had booked.
Come on, then.
That wasn't the intention. That was over my looks.
Stay safe. Stay away. Don't want you home today. Keep away from our door. Don't come round here no more.
Come here now.
Our dad don't wanna know. He says,
what?
This is a serious matter.
Right, Dad.
Too late to reconsider.
Come on, mate.
No one's gonna wanna know ya.
Our mum, she don't wanna know, she says. I'm feeling twice as old, she says. But she had her head on her shoulder.
Cause I'm feeling twice as older. I'm feeling twice as older.
Knock 'em dead.
Yeah.
At least this time you're not gonna be interviewed by a dog.
No.
Okay, so then, Mr. Casey,
yeah.
What makes you think you'd make a good waiter here at the International House of Waffles?
Well, I love meeting people, I'm very hardworking, and I'm quick to learn.
Uh-huh.
I'm also proud to sit here and say that I'm a reformed young offender.
A simple equation. The right path is hard, but the wrong path you run and you'll just keep on running. If he gets involved with a scumbag like Reesey on the last day of school, we know where that path will lead.
The junior sales manager of London Alarms Limited.
Now hang on, this is the wrong path. I mean bad follows
Casey's bad. Casey's the name. Joe Casey.
Hardly looks old enough. How long you been in this business, son?
Well, pretty much since the last day of school, really. See, this friend and I decided the world of business was a bit more exciting.
Well, I didn't stay at school either, Mr. Casey. And it never did me any harm.
Yeah.
Anyway, I shall leave you in the very capable hands of Heather. She deals with all my properties.
OK. Goodbye, Mr. Pressman.
Hang on, is that Mr. Pressman as in what you see up on the cranes?
Pressman Development. Yes, that's him.
And is he moving in here?
No, this one's actually a birthday present he's bought for his secretary.
He buys houses for his staff.
It usually buys him something back.
Anyway, I've been all around your property and I have to say the existing alarm layout is pretty sufficient.
Really?
Absolutely. The only loophole is that one single unalarmed downstairs window. Chances of anybody discovering that are very slight.
Right.
What about that your utility room has no alarm sensor?
No.
What about that you have a slight weakness in the existing alarm layout where someone has put a stud wall in front of the infrared, allowing unmonitored access into the lounge and garage?
Cheers, mate. I've told you this little business idea would work.
No.
Hello, girls.
What the hell are you doing?
Yeah, I thought you didn't want to end up housebreaking like your dad.
Yeah, so did I.
Up. Received a letter just the other day. Read that and you'll see.
I've had second thoughts about that alarm system. We had a minor break-in on Thursday night, so perhaps you'd like to give us a quote on the alarm.
Here we go, boys.
Here, Joe.
Rising star, Mr. Joe Casey. As district manager here at London Alarms, let me congratulate you on your recent sales. 16 alarms is a new company record.
He's an encouragement.
An encouragement.
A living endorsement.
An endorsement.
The promise that he has shown.
The promise.
This is the start of a long-term relationship.
This isn't crime, this is enterprise culture.
Son, go.
God. Billy, Angie, hi.
Joe, look, I know this sounds crazy, but I really fancy some tartan trousers. Do you have any idea round here where I might be able to get some?
Very good.
So this is the job you told everyone you got in marketing?
Girls.
Oh, dear.
Wouldn't it be terrible if Sarah found out the grim truth?
Look, just
especially
don't...
now she's at university.
Don't tell her.
Whole new social circle.
Don't tell
mixing
her.
Mixing with all those high rollers.
Like Callum, for instance, whose father owns a distillery.
Who?
Mind you, saying that, Billy, it does seem for the first time Joe Casey's got a real direction in life.
Look, will you just leave it out, all right? I'm trying to earn a quick bit of cash so I can do something for her birthday.
Yeah? Hey, well, better be good, I tell ya. Because she's used to better things now.
Yeah, well, if university was that glamorous, she wouldn't be working weekends in a bar.
Yeah.
Hey, Jojo.
You all right, Reese? How's it going?
So tell me, just exactly how much have you got to impress the birthday girl with?
Oh, it's not really impressing. It's more what I'm doing is 80 quid.
Come here. See that lovely little convertible Jaguar? 80 quid. You can borrow that for the day.
Is it yours?
No. But what a difference 2 minutes would make. Vroom, vroom.
It's all right, Reese, I'm not getting into all that. But you have just given us an idea. This is going to be the most brilliant birthday present ever.
Here we go. 1 o'clock, corner of Casey Street. Come on.
Let me tell you, this is going to be your most disappointing birthday ever.
Shut it. You should have just stayed at the University Hall's residence and invited us to a massive party.
Girls!
Or something.
All smiles.
We're here.
Yes. Ready for the spectacle? Bring it on!
Hey!
Goodbye!
Hey! Hey.
This
come
fantastic.
On in!
This
come
is on. A joke!
I've been driving in my car. It's not quite a Jaguar. From a bloke from Brazil. 80 quid.
That much?
It was made in 59.
Whoa! That new?
In a factory by the time.
Oh my God, it's Northern.
It says Morris on the door. The GPO owned it before. I drive in it for my job. The governor calls me a slob. But I don't really care.
You should.
Give me some gas in the open air.
Here we go.
Oh, but it's mine. I'm in it in my spare time. Just last week I changed the oil, the rocker valves and the coil.
Just last week it changed the oil. Last week it went round the clock. I also had a little knock. I then hit somebody's fender. My car. It don't look much where I've been far. I drive up to Muswell Hill. I've even been to Selsyville. I drove along the A45. I had her up to 58.
Oh,
don't look much, but I've been far.
Don't look much, full stop.
What?
I mean, full stop. Yeah. Yeah.
God, I love this car.
So anyway, happy birthday to you.
It's still a great birthday.
It's all right, we can push it back.
Yeah. Sorry, don't do push.
No. Hello, Reese. Guess what's happened?
Just get it up on the verge and we'll call someone out.
What? Like a priest?
Oh, that is such... Oh, you know why I love that car?
Yeah?
Because it's so Joe Casey. It's just so you. It's
an embarrassment, you mean?
Listen. Christmas, Joe, at university, we have this big, massive ball. This charity ball, where everyone has to dress up in big frocks. The girls.
Oh.
And the blokes have to have dinner jackets. Okay. And I'm on the organising committee, so I get 2 free tickets.
Sarah, the job in marketing is in fact standing on a street corner with a sign saying golf sale on my head.
Well, I could hire a dinner suit for you.
It's okay.
Serious. I've got this job working weekends at a bar on the embankment. I don't mind paying for you.
Sarah. I don't want charity.
Why can't I explain? Everything I say, he doesn't understand.
The wrong way.
Dark versus light, the simple equation of wrong versus right.
Right, baby,
oh,
let's
God
go!
Almighty.
I like driving in my car.
Here we are, sir. I think you'll like this one. It's a twin car, 4-litre petrol
engine. It is indeed a Jaguar. It says V8 on the door. Finished trim and corridor.
Climate controlled automatically.
Very nice. Very, very nice. Cheers, mate. Thank you very much.
Look at you. Oh, my God almighty.
It's a great day, Mum. It's a great day for dancing.
Great. Come on, then.
Oh, God, no, I didn't mean really.
What nice on him, Kath, is the bloody Don Corleone of Camden.
Did I ever tell you about the time?
Yes.
How me and your dad
won the competition for the world's greatest dancer on Margate Pier with the simplest dance in the universe.
I've mentioned it before, haven't I?
Yes, it has cropped up. Listen, Mum, I don't sell alarms anymore.
Oh?
I'm like my great-granddad. You've got another builder in the family. There you go.
Casey Properties. That's very posh.
Oh, it's a bit small at the moment, Mum, but I promise you, one day it'll be massive. It'll be up on cranes like Pressman's.
Does that mean I'd see even less of you now?
I promise you, Mum, you'll be proud of that name.
I am already.
And that's not
I
all.
Said I am already.
I set Emma and Lewis up in a limousine business.
Limousines? You are kidding.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I give you a...
We've been driving in our car.
And what's it got, boys?
Fish tank and a cinema.
Tell me everything.
It is the biggest car.
5.8 litre, genuine, USA, left-hand drive.
It is the biggest car.
28,000 miles, only ever driven in California.
It is the biggest car.
Is it a big car, Emo?
It is the biggest car.
Joe, I have to ask. I mean, all this money. The money that's paid for the limo. Guys, the alarm scam was to get me the money to set up legit. I will never have to deal with scumbags like Reese again in my life.
Yes, gentlemen, okay? What can I get you?
God, she's a dead ringer for that girl we knew at school.
It is her, Emma.
It is me. Hello, Emma.
Hey, surely actually what you mean is hello, E, of E and L limousines.
What a brilliant name.
Yeah, E stands for Emma.
Oh, no.
And L stands...
We're an investment of a young businessman.
So, Joe Casey getting into property?
I seem to remember he was doing that the last time we met. Cocktails?
Please tell me you went to university.
Can I take your order?
Hey, what's it like, university? Is it like everybody, right, just has sex with everyone else, just like all the time?
We do jobs at weekends to afford it. That's what it's like. Order?
Three of them melon ones, please.
Thanks.
Did you have a good birthday?
I was on a committee all day for a charity ball.
A charity ball? Well, can anyone come?
Let's go check on the limo.
Hey? It'll be halfway through the wax. Oi. Right.
You could come, Joe. But charity involves doing things for other people. Depends if you're into that.
Equation starts simple, but in the long run gets harder to recognize rain from the sun. Wrong turning right, good turning bad.
Well, well, well,
leave us alone, eh, Reese?
Don't turn me away, Jojo. It's just a little job, and look, I planned it all nice and convenient. It's on your way home from work. Slightly open front window.
Look, I told you, I'm not getting into all that.
It'll pay for a DJ. And knowing your luck, tonight will be the night she meets someone else. Hey? It's not your fault you can't get a job. It's not your fault your dad doesn't own a distillery.
What do I have to do?
It's the days that separate the night. The shadows by which we recognize the light.
Oh my God! Finally, I start to live. Woo! I'm in a ball dress, I'm in a university, yes. I've achieved so much, and it's only half past seven.
Oh, Callum. Billy, Angie, this is Callum. Organise all this with me.
You must be our friends from Camden.
Islington. Yes, Islington. Yeah,
right. So tell me, what exactly is Heron House?
It's a stately home they converted into apartments. So anyway, I'm Callum. I bet there's some family history behind those trousers.
Oh, my God, the band's finished. Can you check the next band?
Yeah, look, I'll check the next band. Yes, Captain. Good night, ladies.
Good night. Look at that.
What? Not wanting to say, I told you so. But just imagine all those years back if you ended up going out with Joe Casey, then come to a place like this.
It would be like being tied to a donkey in a field full of stallions.
Girls, well, you don't mind. I brought a donation.
Casey Properties.
Joe didn't have to do that.
Yes, well, that's the point of charity, isn't it? Besides, I didn't want to waste all these dancing lessons. Yeah?
I can't. Seriously.
Girls.
Alas, time to go. Sorry, don't do dance.
Could you?
Just this once.
Thanks. Come on, let me teach you. This is the simplest dance in the universe. On you go. And again. Okay, other arm. Now step back and pull. That's it. Right, same arm, right leg. Step. Other side. Now both arms step through and let me do the work, okay? That's it. Got it. That's all it is.
Where did you learn all this?
The Camden International Academy of Dance. It's above the Electric Rhino sex shop. My mum taught me.
Thank you.
Why'd you come here tonight, Joe?
Well, I'd like to say it's because I support Oxfam, but I just didn't. God, you know, I spent so long, so many nights going back over that night at Camden Keys, running away, putting myself before you. It was the biggest mistake I ever made.
Yeah, it
the
was.
One that lost me you. Come here. You know, sometimes, Sarah, I find myself fantasizing that I actually did the right thing that night and gave myself up to the police. And how brilliant life would have turned out.
Get a little scumbag!
Better run, Jojo!
Nothing. Come on, love, ain't done nothing.
Lads, the game's leaving.
I'll tell you why I didn't do it, cause I wasn't there. Don't blame me, it just isn't fair. Don't listen to his side, just listen to mine. Can't think of a story, sure you'll find me sometime. Now pass the blame and don't blame me. Just close your eyes and count to three.
One, two, three!
Then I'll be gone and you'll forget. The broken window TV set.
It wasn't me either, I'm just his mate.
Mate! He told me to stand there and watch the gate.
No, he didn't, he's
I've
not.
I've got a wife and three kids, you know.
No, he hasn't.
They'll tell you I'm straight, at least I think so.
Look, officer, I'm as honest as the day is long.
Yeah, right! The longer the daylight, the less I do wrong.
Now pass the blame and don't blame me. Just close your eyes and count to three.
We're here for you, mate. We called Sarah and she's on her way down.
What?
What?
You called Sarah?
Was that wrong?
Oh, you idiots. You brain-dead, stupid idiots.
Oi, Joe. Don't push it.
Joe, what's happened?
Thanks a lot, guys. Thanks so much, yeah?
They said you're broken into a house.
Who's this?
What?
What did we do?
Yeah, the name's Callum.
They said you were arrested breaking into a house.
Oh, look, I just came out of the bar with a
that's all. What the hell were you trying?
Whose jacket?
Forget the jacket, Joe. Why are you trying to break into a house?
Because we don't all have one of them lying about.
What?
Nice one, mate. Nice jacket.
But I offered to pay
so
for
what,
it.
So what, Sarah? So I go around with everyone knowing you paid for your boyfriend's clothing at
hey,
the...
Hey, Roman!
Sorry. Yeah, look, I just think she meant that...
Joe, I'm sorry we called her,
no,
yeah?
No, 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 go on. Tell me what you think my girlfriend meant.
Come here!
Look, I just think Sarah was trying to be nice.
Don't use that name.
Hey, what is happening to
calm
you?
Calm it down, Sarah.
Forget it, Emma. Yeah, come on, Sarah, just leave.
I say, don't use that name.
No! 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 Don't hit a copper. Never! Never hit a copper!
Hold on.
Hold on. Don't send him where I went.
No, look. He doesn't belong with these lot. He's not like them. He's not a criminal.
He did the right thing.
He's done the right thing all the way.
I'll tell you what the right thing would have been, Sarah. When I was 16. To have never met you!
No, no, darling, listen, no, he doesn't mean that. Listen, he was trying to do the right thing. Listen, darling, he was trying.
Trying hard, I thought I'd done my best. All my life, I can't get no rest. Down and down, there is no up, I think that I'd run.
I hear them say,
it's just another day.
I hear them say,
it gets better every day.
I hear them say,
it's just another day. Tomorrow's just another day.
Walking now over covered ground. There is a chance if I move around. I need a moment to reflect on the friendships I have wrecked.
I hear them say, tomorrow's just another day. I hear them say, and it gets better every day. I hear them say, tomorrow's just another day.
white and night is day, and paths we take stretch far away. How can we ever hope to call? Which will rise and which will fall?
It's raining again. A crack in the clouds reveals blue sky. I've been feeling so low, but now everything is on my side. The sun and the rain walk with me, fill my heart again. I feel the rain falling on my face. I can say there is no better place. Standing up in the falling down, in so much rain I could almost drown.
I hear them say,
tomorrow's just another day.
I hear them say,
and it gets better every day.
I hear them say,
tomorrow's just another day.
Ladies and gentlemen, the casino.
Cheers, mate.
God, I love Las Vegas.
Let's go!
Look at that.
Let's move.
I have just seen a car.
We got rowed to our room.
I have just seen a car.
We got rowed to our room.
I have just seen a car.
Oh, for crying out loud.
So big, it can never turn round.
Take a photo?
Yeah, of course.
Oh. Oh. Thank you. Oh, and they're getting married. Oh. We got married here 20 years ago. Oh. Thank you so much and all the best for your future.
Mr. Pressman. I sold you a house alarm once. You said how you hadn't stayed in school either. I even got into property like you, North London. I took your lead. Joe Casey.
Hey, I'm looking for someone in North London.
Huh.
Call me.
Whoa. Oh,
Pressman's business card. Could this day get any better?
Right. Well, bearing in mind, this isn't the Church of the Blessed Virgin in Kentish Town Road. And my wedding car was a flaming gondola. I hope your bridesmaids are properly dressed for a good Catholic service.
Oh my God!
Oh my God! I'm in a designer dress, I'm in Las Vegas, I've achieved so much and I'm only 21.
Now, Sybil, honey, you know I've always dreamt that you would have a paradise wedding. Baby, you got it!
Hey. Woo!
look up at the rooftops. When you're walking round, don't think for a moment of looking down.
Whoa, whoa, for the wings of a dove. Whoa, whoa, for the wings of a dove. Whoa, whoa, for the wings of a dove. Whoa, whoa, for the wings of a dove.
I do.
That go for you?
Yeah.
Well, that's good enough for me. Let's party!
Yeah! Look up at the rooftops. When you're walking round, don't think for a moment of looking down.
Hey.
A room at the top, where we're not allowed.
Hey.
Cheers to the echo.
Arlington House, address no fixed abode. An old man in a three-piece suit sits in the road. He stares across the water and sees right through the lock. But on and up like outstretched hands, his mumbled words, his fumbled words mock. Surrounded by his past, on a short white line, he sits while cars pass either side. Takes his time, he's trying to remember one better day. A while ago, when people stop to hear him say, walk
walking round you sometimes, hear the sunshine beating down in time with the rhythm of your shoes.
Kath?
Any sign of Joe yet? What do the prisons say?
They say they let him out last Friday.
Right.
What is it that I'm doing, Father? Why do they not come home?
She's trying to remember one better day. A while ago when people stopped to hear her say,
walking round you sometimes, hear the sunshine beating down in time with the rhythm of your shoes. The feeling of arriving when you've nothing left to lose.
Walking round you sometimes.
I know exactly why you're not going home, son.
Hear the sunshine.
I stood here so many nights when I come out of prison.
Beating down in time with the rhythm of your shoes.
I stood here. And I'm thinking, what right has a worthless ex-con like me to set foot into 25 Casey Street?
I remember way back then when everything was true and when we would have such a very good time, such a fine time, such a happy time.
I remember how we'd play, simply waste a day away. Then we'd say nothing would come between us. To dream
again. Hey, lover boy, there's a dancing competition down the pier. Let's go watch it. Have a laugh.
Bank holiday, Margate. Sweet memory.
Bank holiday, boyfriend. Drunk before we reach the sea.
Magic about the pier. Moonlight about her hair.
He almost put his back out, trying to drag me up the stairs.
Underfoot,
the dance floor was melting,
crumbling.
For the
luckiest pair, the whole world was melting.
Look, I'm not entering a flaming dance contest. No, I've got some big news.
No, that is the simplest dance in the universe.
Sticky carpets, cigarette burns, cracked mirror ball.
Sea ripples making shadows, promenade hall.
Each other's fur to reach. All words unsaid. We danced like Stan and Ollie.
But it felt like Ginger and Fred.
Oh, will you stop it? I've got something to tell you.
What?
You're going to be a dad.
Are you kidding? And it's definitely mine.
Well, it's either yours or Clint Eastwood's.
God, oh, wow. We might be having Clint Eastwood's baby.
Are you going to ask me to marry you then or what?
You betcha.
Oh.
The whole world was melting, crumbling, for the luckiest pair. And all I wanted was a word. This is it, number 25 Casey Street.
Okay, I'll do this on my own.
Okay, Mr. Pressman. Joe?
Kath, Harold Pressman. Pressman Development?
Look, I haven't, to be honest, had time to think about your offer, Mr. Pressman. I've had a few other things on my plate.
It's only because I do care here, Kath. I really want you to get the best deal with this house. My offer does decrease each week. Is that how it works in this business?
I know.
It's not often the boss of a company comes down in person, you know.
Good night, Mr. Pressman.
I take it you are thinking about moving out.
I said good night, Mr. Pressman.
It's going to be fabulous down here, Kath. Big canal side promenade, lights in the steps, marble, lots of stuff that looks like marble. I leave my card in the old letterbox. Stubborn Irish cow.
These are the streets I used to walk on summer nights, sit out and talk. That's the house where I used to live. I remember what I would give.
Go in the house, Joe. Don't find excuses not to.
I got your business card. This house is not gonna fall, Mr. Pressman. We used to live where children play. They'd leave their homes a mile away to come and stand in trees and grass where we once walked the memories past. Being here again, I can recall forgotten moments, the rise and fall. This is the town I won't forget, and after anger, there's nothing left. Walking now, round and round, familiar sights are open ground. Being here again, I can recall forgotten moments, the rise and fall. The sun shines east, the sun shines west, but I know where the sun shines best.
Casey Street in the afternoon, once again it's over too soon.
Next Tuesday. Thanks, Jill.
Good morning, miss.
Can I help you, sir?
Yes, I'm meeting Mr. Pressman. He said 9:30. My name's Joe Casey.
From Las Vegas, sir. Please, sir, this way, please. Just take a seat in the atrium there, sir. There's newspapers and journals and a cappuccino machine on your right. And if you need help propping your milk, I'll finish at 6. Mr. Pressman, this is Julie on reception. The young man here that you met when you were renewing your vows with your wife in America. I've sent him through. Yes, he can do 3 o'clock next Tuesday. Thanks, Jill.
Good morning, miss.
What?
I'd like to speak to Mr. Is it Pressman?
Right. Sit through there. Don't touch the plants. And I've counted all those magazines. I said don't touch the plants. Come in.
Coming. Joe Casey.
Mr. Pressman.
From Las Vegas.
That's right.
My protege property developer.
It's in the blood. My family, we're all builders.
Well, you're going to make them really proud.
Oh, God, I mean, I hope so.
Little story, Joe.
Right.
This old estate we're building on, council-owned. We can boot them out, but it's like spanner in the works.
Yeah.
One house seems to be a little reluctant. How to put it, in need of you, a local lad who speaks their language, to explain what a bloody good idea it'd be to leave number 25 Casey Street.
Number 25 Casey Street.
I mean, normally, if we ever need help getting a stubborn sod out of a house, we have the option of this man. His name's Danny, and by all means, if you need
help... I don't need him.
I can sort this out.
On Friday the 1st, the cranes go
then
up.
I'll do this by Friday the 1st.
And in the east, a new sun will rise.
Hey?
Picture this, Joe. Up there, across Camden skies. Pressman casing. On Friday the 1st. If that witch is out of Casey Street.
Okay.
No link, I take it. Joe Casey Street.
No.
8 o'clock, Marjorie, 8 o'clock is fine. I've said I'll come and I'll see you outside. Yes. Right, I've got to go now. I've got someone coming to see me. Coming. Joe Cozy.
Casey.
Casey, come right in, please do. Tell me what you want. That's what I'm here for. Off you go.
Right, now I may have got this wrong last night, but I thought I'd overheard some plans for Casey Street. Now the thing
my wife's mad at me.
My mum lives at number 25 Casey Street, which is on the
edge. I didn't want to see the show tonight.
No, it's on the east end of the
She finds it hard to take.
If you let me draw you a little map, can you imagine all this area?
She thinks I've had enough of her.
Casey Street runs down the middle.
Why can't she see?
It cuts the whole area in half. Now
she's lovely to me.
Every little company. I'm going to be making some kind of
but tragically not as nice as Julie in reception, who's 19.
Were you even listening to me?
Just for your information, the last man who raised his finger to me was very, very sorry he did. Boys, can you escort Mr. Cozy through the very special visitor's exit?
Hang on, stop it. OK, if you want to fight, that's what you've got, cos I'm going to get a lawyer and I'm going to save Casey
right,
Street!
Danny, this is Harold Pressman. When you get this, give me a call on the usual number. I need a property in Casey Street to stop being an issue.
Courtesy of Casey Properties.
Cheers.
Didn't I tell you? Didn't I say that Joe Casey was a hot catch who was going to come good?
No. You said he was a worthless no-oper who was surrounded by gormless prats.
Meaning who?
Right, brilliant. We're all in. Now then, Friday the 1st is a very special day.
Oh, yeah. It's Auntie Kath's birthday. Tell you what we're going to give her. All night out in the limo, you know, round the West End. Champagne, Chinese, and a video of Daniel O'Donnell. What do you reckon?
Brilliant. Look at my present, pass it round. Honest to God, sir, I really think Mr. Pressman is going to take me on as a partner for this one. Can you imagine that? Mum seeing that up on the cranes. Pressman! Casey! Yeah?
Who's the bloke with the dog?
No one. Bloody hell, Emma, it's an artist's impression of what they're going to look like.
Camden Key West.
For all she's done for everyone over the years, for bringing me up without my dad, for taking these two in and bringing them up like her own kids.
So the bloke with the dog's got nothing to do with it?
A lovely little flat. What do you reckon?
Shame, cos it'd be nice to have a dog like that walking about the garden.
Emma.
Joe, your mum would never move out of Casey Street.
Well, yeah, it's her castle.
It is Casey Street.
You what?
Well, Boulevard.
Yeah? Casey Boulevard?
That's one.
You're going to knock down Casey Street?
It's not knocking down, it's regeneration. Like Mr. Pressman said, all things have got to fall for things to rise.
Well, does she want to move? Yes.
No. Because, like I said, it's her castle.
Yes, well, it'd stop feeling like a bloody castle if people stopped treating it like one.
Goodbye, Joe.
Hey. Hey! Let me remind you who bought you that limo.
Yeah. You bought the limo, Joe. Not the driver.
Oh, right. Are we... We're not... Right.
Actually, can we scabbalip into town?
You haven't even... Oh, are you not gonna... Look, this is proper stuff, you know, Ange.
See you later, sir.
What sort of... Bloody hell, when these are supposed to be our friends? God, you know, sometimes, Sarah, I just don't
If you don't get your mum out of Casey Street, Will you still get your name up in the sky?
Sarah, by Friday, those cranes go up. Two choices. Either they've got my name on them or they haven't. Now, I think
it's... Nicole, you never consider putting up a fight.
Sarah, some things you can't fight. Instead, you just get the people you love the best deal.
Very good. Did Mr. Pressman teach you that? Same as always buy people presents because it'll buy you something back.
Look, it's about safety, okay, for Mum, who spent her whole life worrying about that scum from the high rise she thought was going to break in. Well, there'd be gates, okay? There'd be steps with lights in, there'd be marble. Well, lots of stuff that
looks like marble. Yeah. Have you heard what you sound like?
Just to remind you, we did get married. Bit of support, yeah?
You earn support, Joe. You don't marry it! Suddenly, after all this time, a boy stands there in front of me. A boy I thought had gone, a boy from history. Who let me down, preferring his own destiny. Now there's the strangest feeling that's come over me. Oh, the look in your eyes as you turn to leave. A look I haven't seen in years. The way I feel is so unreal. Like time still until now. Although it seems unfair, I feel you slip through my arms again. Oh, now. Although the memory's bare, I feel you slip through my arms again. Please understand that you were like an angel glowing in my hands. But circumstances change, as do their demands. You say you fight for what you love, but in the end, there'll be only ugly scenes and reprimands. Oh, the look in your eyes as you turn to leave. The clutches of my breaking heart. I stand alone, all hope torn, court orders drawn.
No. Any other project, 100%. 100%. But this Irish estate, I mentioned it to my friends and my wife, and to be honest, it's a little bit... Look, is there any other maybe smaller project I could start
with? Hey, there is no other project, Joe! If you can't act this, you might as well wimp out back to the minor league and spend your life doing up flats. I've told you, if you can't do it with words, you do it with muscle. Use the card, call Danny.
Oh, the look in your eyes as you turn to leave. The clutches of my breaking heart. I stand alone, all hope torn, court orders drawn. Like time stood still until now. Although it seems unfair,
the other day.
Go on.
Young man wants to fight Pressman Developers.
Excellent.
Well, I gave him a note of our usual fees.
Tremendous.
But he says he doesn't have any money.
Goodbye.
Hello.
You're not to come see. us no more.
But I haven't even walked through the
door. Keep away from our door. Shoo! Try Harper Smith Massey of Hampstead. Slightly smaller, younger, cheaper.
Total bastards, those big-time developers.
They just think money, despise them the right.
And connections and power. God, they think money is everything.
And the thing is, I've got no money to fight them.
Well, then you're not to come see us no more.
Hey?
Keep away from our door.
No, no, but you just...
Try that legal aid place.
Camden High Street. Used to be the electric rhino sex shop.
Okay, let's weigh up what we've got here. On the one hand, multi-million pound developer. On the other, a bloke on legal aid. I think I'll give this to our trainee. Sarah?
Yeah, okay, 10 minutes. Tell him to come up now, I've a kind of hard person. God, I'm in Camden Magistrates Court midday on that police bail thing, so I can't.
Lunch.
Yeah.
Lunch. Let me remind you. Get your hands off my girl.
Oh my God.
Joe Casey!
Don't hit me again.
I'm sorry about all that, mate.
Hey, nah, sure, that's fine.
What are you doing here, Joe?
I need a lawyer.
Now what have you done?
No, it's not like that. I'm on a mission. I'm trying to save Casey Street. See, there's these developers, and... Look, maybe I'd better find another solicitor to help me with it, because it doesn't...
No, hold on. Callum, you have to go.
Oh, charming.
No, I mean, Billy and Angie are coming up with the wedding dress. It's incredibly bad luck.
All right, that's fine. I'll see you later, mate.
Wedding. Congratulations. I think I've been here before. It used to be the Electric Rhino sex shop. I bought a condom here that played a tune.
That was you playing the power and love out your back pocket.
Listen. You get married. I'll get somebody else to help me with Casey Street. The night I hit Callum and I said I wished I'd never met you, that was such a lie. That was another boy who said that, sir. Because every day people spend with you, it makes their life better.
Stop, please.
I hope you're happy, sir. I never met anybody who deserves to be happy more than you.
Now I want you back in my arms again. Oh, now. Although the memories bear, I want you back in my arms. Tell me how we got here now. Sue, can you get me the Camden Town Housing Records office?
Danny! Is that Danny? Harold Pressman gave me this number. Is your name Danny?
The Christian one.
Reese, what the hell are you doing here?
Hello, Jojo. I'm working for Harold Pressman, same as you. I heard you've gone legit. Or are you about to prove otherwise?
On the night of Friday the 1st, no one will be in at number 25 Casey Street. A couple of the lads are taking the owner round the West End in a limo for her birthday.
Number 25?
Yeah.
Isn't that your house, Joby?
I just need you to break in. Nothing else.
I have done this before, Casey. Off now. Meet me at Camden Lock with the other half immediately after it's done.
I just need that house to stop feeling like a castle.
Camden Lock! Jojo!
It's the simple equation of wrong versus right, the terror of standing one North London night, hoping you'd shown your son the right way, and now watching right's going wrong, white going grey. Show me now which way's high. Is this the earth? Is that the sky? And if I knew if things were clear, could I even make him hear? Oh, God, I'm sorry, Joe. Whatever path you choose off that balcony, you mess your life up! Or maybe it's in the blood. Maybe it was me messed your life up.
Dad?
Joe?
Sarah? What are you doing here?
Looking for you.
Sarah, that was the weirdest thing.
Are you sleeping on that?
Have you been crying?
You haven't been home since you come out of prison, have you? Your mum is spending half her life in a church praying for you to come back. And you're sleeping here on this bloody bench.
Sarah, please don't shout at me.
You said... When you came in the office, you said you were trying to save Casey Street. Tell me what you meant.
Okay. It's a man called Pressman. The company's called Pressman's. Now, oh, they're the ones that built all them lot up there. Now, what I think it is they're planning to do is make some kind of development on the Irish estate.
I never thought I'd miss
you. And this means that they're going to be knocking down Casey Street and number 25. Now, I don't know if they're off my mum any money or what the whole legal situation is. I mean, I don't know anything about Lord Sarah.
And I never thought I'd feel this way, the way I feel about you.
He's got a whole lot of lawyers and solicitors back, and in 1 minute he stood there, he's being nice as part of my mum. Next minute he's calling her a stubborn Irish cow.
As soon as I wake up, every night, every day, I know that it's you I need to take the blues away. It must be love, love, love. It must be love, love, love. Nothing more, nothing less. Love is the best.
How can it be
what I did
that
was, I looked up the deeds. Just in
case. Say so much.
Just in case there was someone I could
without
do to
words.
Help. Look at this. I found this. I had to pull a few
bless
strings,
you and bless me.
This might be.
Bless the bees.
The document.
And the birds.
Yeah, good enough this. Look. Starts there, read that.
I've got to be near you every night. Every day, I couldn't be happy any other way. It must be love, love, love. It must be love, love, love. Nothing more, nothing less. Love is the best.
When we were 16, that night sitting here, you thought it was some old story of your mum's that the family was given the house. She was right, Joe. 25 Casey Street was given to your family forever. This might be enough. This might be enough to save Casey Street.
This is incredible, Sarah. It's incredible. You're incredible, Sarah.
I've got to be near you every night, every day.
I know that it's you I need to chase the blues away. It must be love, love, love. It must be love, love, love. It must be love, love, love. It must be love.
What date is it?
The first.
The first.
Friday the first.
Friday the first. It's her birthday. It's my mum's birthday. I can take this and show her. What a day.
You got your dream. You're proving my mates wrong, Mr. Casey.
Yeah, yeah. And you got yours. You're a lawyer. So what's that make you now? Mrs. What is it?
I didn't get married, Joe.
What? Why?
No matter how much you love someone, there's times in life you can't say yes.
I didn't know. That's really sad. Could this day get any better? I'm coming home, Mum! It's raining again. A crack in the clouds, wind feels blue sky. I've been feeling so low. But now everything is on my side. The sun and the rain. Walk with me, feel my heart again. I feel the rain falling on my face. I can say there is no better place than standing up in the falling down. In so much rain I could almost drown.
Who will buy my Indian joss sticks? Incense burners direct from Nepal.
Such fine offensive t-shirts. With words of sin designs.
Look at my white exotic parts out. Made from something you must already eat. Look at
ripe cannabis.
I feel the rain falling on my face.
it wet in the street. Reflecting the light and splashing feet. Nowhere to go. And nothing I have to do. Come on, Reese!
Oh, hey, Joe!
All right, mate. Emma, Lewis, what the hell are you two doing here?
We're getting T-shirts, prints in the market. Look, E&L limousines.
What did you do with Mum's trip round the West End in the limousine, huh?
Oh, right. Well, she won't come.
What?
Well, in the end, I mean, she insisted on waiting for you to come round. What with it being her birthday and that?
No.
Well, she's still in Casey's.
No, 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 no.
No, what?
Reese!
To come home.
But it's gone, Mum. It's gone, and you could have been in there. Christmas would have got so many.
You came back to me, Joe Casey. Not the house. This is our house now.
Police reckon it was someone breaking in who dropped a firebomb. It's good that, isn't it? I mean, you should have told us you had something planned, Joe. We would have tried harder to get her in the limo.
Come here, big man.
Get off.
Oh, don't you dare. Don't you dare cry now.
It's my mum.
Yeah. She is now. On Friday. She was the woman you wanted out of Casey Street.
Come on!
Hey, Joe. It's a good thing Sarah went into law.
Yeah. I reckon you're gonna need it.
Was it Joe? You didn't have anything to do with this.
Sarah, we might have to reinforce the truth just a little bit.
Oh my God!
No. Just to be safe, In case you'll ask, was it me who wanted my mum out of Casey Street? Just to be safe. For the future, yeah, for the both of us. Just to be safe, you would say the right thing, wouldn't you?
No matter how much you love someone, Joe, there's times in life you can't say yes.
Suddenly wrong turns back to right. black turns slowly back to white. Skies all suddenly come clear. We see how we got to here.
Joseph Casey, you have named Daniel Rees as an accomplice. You will be remanded pending further investigation into the charges of arson and manslaughter brought against you by the Crown.
I need a moment to reflect on the friendships I have wrecked.
They're coming up the path.
Oi, camera over here.
Hey?
Yeah, come on.
You sound like his motorbike.
What?
Yeah. Whatever.
Did you get him a wedding present?
Yeah, I got him a surprise Harmony condom. Well, it's nice for a young couple, you know. I mean, they don't work, right? But they do mean that your kids grow up very musical. Here she comes.
Hey.
Honey Cam!
There's one thing about the registry office, it's a bloody sight shorter than the Catholic service.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mrs. Casey!
Sarah, this is now our mum. Our MO. Our Lewis. And your mates.
Let's hit Primrose Hill and party!
Emma, you've got a decent body, do you know that?
Oh, yeah, I thought I might take my top off and all.
No.
Fair point.
Come on, yeah. Photograph.
Yeah. Me and your dad used to come up here, you know, with you. For the view. I wish he was around for you, golden boy.
I don't think Dad's ever coming home, Mum.
I know.
I wanted to tell her. I wanted her to know.
Mum, I think with everything that's happened, I think now I understand how Dad could have had too much pride and he could have made mistakes. And he could have hurt you.
I loved her so much.
But he loved you so much.
It's taking. Come on.
Five, four, three.
I miss you so much, Dad.
Yeah. I miss you, Joey.
I wish I'd done things differently.
Look, if you end up with the people that you love around you, then you are doing the right thing.
Oi, do we get married or what?
Two, one!
Lens cap.
Oh, Emma.
Smile.
Yeah!
I knew, you and me, that we were supposed to end up together. And I don't care what anyone else thinks, Joe Casey.
I want to go into law, and it's because I reckon I'm a pretty good judge of character.
Well, I'm not going to end up like him. Come on. Let me show you something.
Hey, I was going to kiss you then.
It's important.
Joe, what the hell are you doing?